Hey, welcome in. Well, just a quick note on Monica Lewinsky here first. She's been back in the news again recently. I guess she's got this new documentary, 15 Minutes of Shame. But anyway, I just saw this picture of her, and you know what? She looks great. She looks better than she did in the day. Who says cigars aren't good for you? Anyway, moving on. Here's something I don't actually find all that surprising. Here's the headline. New study finds 42% would get under the covers with a robot. Well, I certainly get why men would do this. I mean, let's just take a look at some of the things women are reading these days. Here's from Bold Day, which is a women's magazine. Here's some recent stories. How to ignore a guy to get his attention. Does ignoring him really make him like you more? So thanks for the mind games there. How about this? 10 signs he's not capable of loving you the way you deserve, in your own opinion. That's from the What's the Deal section. The deal is that's way more trouble than it's worth. Let's see, 10 reasons I'm not considered marriage material, and I'm fine with it. I'm going to guess that none of those 10 reasons are that you're awful. How about this? How to be a high-value woman. 6 traits shared by women who know their worth. Yeah, when somebody tells you they know their worth, you can bet they're greatly overestimating their worth. Are the sex robots starting to look better to you yet? But anyway, 42% would get under the covers with a robot. Let's see, a new study by Tidio, the makers of Chatbox, which apparently is a computer program simulating human conversation through voice commands or text chats, found that 42% of those polled said they would have sex with a humanoid robot. And the poll of just over 1,200 people found that 39% felt they'd be able to have a romantic relationship with a non-sentient being. Well, it would have to be pretty realistic seeming, at least more so than, I don't know, a Kardashian. But they're saying here that there was a difference of opinion on this subject between the sexes. So men and women have different preferences, apparently. When it came to the men, 48% wanted to sleep with robots, and 43% thought they could actually fall in love with one. And I don't find this that surprising, because men's standards are not actually that high. They don't have a lot of qualifications that they need. They got to look good. I mean, there's probably not going to be many healthy at any size robots built, right? Nice, right? Nice. I think that's probably easily programmable. Or just not nagging or insulting you. Really, that's good enough. And available. And, well, that's kind of the whole point of them. Again, men aren't that hard to please. Researchers also found men in general were twice as likely to trust artificial intelligence than women. Well, yeah. But hot artificial intelligence. I mean, we have to make that. So, yeah, I mean, we are more likely to be convinced by the artificial intelligence to help it, you know, I don't know, destroy the rest of mankind or something. But you know what they say, happy wife, happy life, right? Now, it doesn't actually tell us what percentage of women would be okay with this. But I'm guessing it probably wouldn't be that much different as long as the AI made more money than they did. Anyway, let's move on. Well, here's a nice story. Michael Jackson's former pet chimp, now living a quiet life in Florida. Oh, that's good to hear. I'm really glad to hear that. I remember that chimp. I'm glad to hear it's doing well. They ask here, ever wonder what happened to Bubbles? Well, not really. I gotta be honest about it, but now that we're here, let's find out. The newspaper reports that Bubbles, now 38, which is late middle age in a chimp's lifespan, makes his home these days far away from the spotlight. The Center for Great Apes in Florida. The chimp reportedly is camera shy, likes listening to flute music, and paints the odd abstract, huh? With one piece selling for just over $5,100 in 2017. Hey, must have a good agent. It says, in his heyday, Bubbles was constantly in the public eye after being adopted as a baby by the King of Pop, who died in a drug overdose in 2009. Jackson and Bubbles were once so inseparable that he went on world tours with the singer, stayed with him in hotel rooms, and dined out in public with him. And I really hope that's as weird as it got. However, ape expert Jane Goodall, 87, alleged in 2014 the chimp had been beaten while living with Jackson and that the singer became upset when she confronted him about it. She said, I went to see him when we talked about Bubbles. I ticked him off. Bubbles is still alive and he's beautiful. But when he was with Michael, he was being beaten. Now I have to wonder about this allegation. Because if there's one thing I know about chimps, they love to rip people's faces off. And they can do it easily. They're built for it. Chimps were born to rip your face off. They love it. It's the thing they like most of all. And they get angry too. And when they get angry, they're really, really strong. And it's really hard to stop them from ripping your face off. So I have to wonder about that. Although when Michael Jackson got that new nose, I don't know. Might there have been just a little bit of face ripping happening there? Like just the nose? I hope that was the case. Because if Michael Jackson just came home one day and he had this new nose, Bubbles probably would have assumed that another chimp had ripped his nose off and then he had to get a new one. I mean, can you imagine how betrayed Bubbles would have felt? But anyway, let's see. In a 2003 documentary, Living with Michael Jackson, Jackson told journalist Martin Bashir that Bubbles was being sent away because he had become too moody and always wanted to fight. So it sounds like Bubbles was depressed, and I don't blame him. I mean, Bubbles might have seen some pretty messed up things, right? I mean, when you think about it, it's kind of a miracle that chimp didn't rip anybody's face off, as far as we know. Anyway, that's all I got to say about that. Please subscribe, like, and share. That really helps me out. If you'd just like to listen, there's the podcast, Radio Baloney. It's on pretty much every platform. If you look for it, you will find it. Thank you very much. I'll see you next time.